Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BOFU Gaming, and today we are back in Garden Wars. Yes, we are. And yeah, finally. I know there's been quite a long break from this, which wasn't really intended, but that's just how it is. Life gets in the way sometimes, and now we're back. And I have actually decided to start a brand new game with a brand new character. Because the game has changed a lot. There's so much that's been added or changed since I started my previous series. And I think it's going to be a little bit of a different experience this time around. So that's why I want to try it. But for those of you who are new to this, even if I change my mind, it's not going to be a problem. So if like in 5 or 10 hours I decide, oh no, I'm not going to do this, I want to just pick up where I left off, then you can have 3 different characters. So I have this character or can create a new one, but even if I choose one of the ones I have, you can also have 3 different worlds. So of course we're going to create one down here, but I still have my old worlds and I can still join them. I can even join them with my new character. You can join any of your worlds with any of your characters. The quests and stuff will of course change depending on which world you are in and what has been built and so on. But you can kind of jump around between them, use whichever character you feel like. You can even bring stuff from one world to the other, depending on how much room you have in your inventory. Then you can bring some stuff between these worlds. So there's a lot of stuff I have in this world. I could choose potentially to bring it over to this world if I want to in the future. And of course there's also a creative mode. I haven't messed with this at all, but the option is there, and as you can see it's still a work in progress, so that's something they're still working on. But I do think this is what I want to do. So also, if you're new to this, you can also play multiplayer, or it's like more like a co-op, I guess. I haven't actually done this at all myself, but I really like the freedom with it, because even though I haven't played any multiplayer, I've played this game for over a year, or it's over a year since I started my main save, I can jump right into this, change my mind now and say, oh, I think I want to start playing with other people. So I choose my main character here. And then I can still use the worlds I already have, or I can choose to create a completely new one if I suddenly want to play with a friend. And then you just give your server a name and you can choose max players. You can give it a password, which of course can be a good idea if you just want to play with a friend or a couple of friends. You can choose which mode you want it to be. Of course, in this case, I would have to make a new world. But other than that, I can jump into here, pick up where I left off, and I can let other people come join me if I don't put a password, and then I can just have random people join me if I want to, or if you meet someone on Discord you want to trade with, if they have, you know, a special skin or whatever that you want to get, or you're missing some resources and they are much further in the game than you, then they might want to trade you or help you out, then they can actually bring that stuff into your world and give it to you, or you can join their world, of course, and do the same, which I think is really, really cool. And then you can just go back to playing, you know, change your world back to, or you don't, if you don't open up a room when you're playing, when you start up the game the next time, you can just go straight back to playing single player and play by yourself. So you can do whatever you feel up to doing on any current day, right? And of course, we have a room list over here if you want to try and join someone else, either a friend where you're probably going to need a password, or you can just kind of jump in and visit random people here, the ones that are open, and, you know, maybe make some new friends or see what people are up to. Most of these are pretty early in the game. There's one here that's year 4, so they might have a bunch of stuff. If you want to see how the game looks when you get to that point, they have probably unlocked a lot of buildings that you don't have if you're new to the game. If you want to just sort it without the ones with password, okay, so there's 5 worlds here that I can join. None of them are full, but if you had like a lot more servers and some of them are full, you can also remove those. There we go. I don't actually know what Cloud Relay does. As I said, I've never played multiplayer or this online mode at all, but I guess it has to do with saving or something. But that kind of brings me to, if we go back to the menu, There is a Discord for the game, and it's a very, very active Discord. There's a lot of active and very passionate players in there. The developers are also active in there, and you can get a lot of help from this one if you have some questions, if there's something you can't figure out, or if you want to know how something gets unlocked or where to find something, or yeah, just if you want to meet some other players. Then I definitely recommend joining this. The developers actually also live stream the game or the development of the game. So if you want to know what they're up to, what is the next thing we're going to get, and you want to see them design, you know, new areas or new items for the game, they also notify that in the Discord, or you can get notified via the Discord of when they go live, and then you can go and join them. They also do a lot of giveaways and stuff during the live streams. So definitely, if you're gonna play Garden Post, do consider joining the Discord. It's very recommended. And then down here we have like patch notes, so you can just see the latest patch notes for the game. There we go. So that was kind of it. Let's just get into this. I just thought I would kind of cover a little bit of this stuff. So of course we're gonna make a new character. We didn't have to, I could just keep playing with one of the other ones, but since we are starting fresh, let's do it. And you are not tied to any of these. You can see there's like 10 different characters you can be, or animals you can be. I really, really, like my favorite, I think, is the, where is it? Oh, it's the one I'm on. It's because I'm looking at the names, but the dragon. I really like the dragon. The chipmunk is really, really cute too. So is the badger. Actually, they are all cute, guys. But you're not tied to this. If I just choose I want to be the chipmunk, then I can choose one of these available skins. But as you're playing the game, you're gonna unlock a whole bunch of new skins. So you can change the skin, the look of your character, at any given time from inside the game. So if you get a new skin, you can just learn it, and you can go into customization in the game and you can change it. You can also change what you want to be. So if you feel like, oh, today I want to be a cat, then you can just change to a cat. If you want to be a dog, you can change to a dog. So it's not going to be like, okay, I'm going to be a chipmunk for the rest of this game at all. You can choose to be. You can choose to just say this character is always going to be a chipmunk if you want to play in character that way. I think we're going to try and be a chipmunk for now, and we're going to pick this red one. You can also change the faces, and this you can also change. So especially if you're playing multiplayer, I could see using this a lot more. I tend to go to these very standard ones. But there's a lot of like funny faces that you can, you know, play around with. Look at that, there's a hard eyes. Or you can do it like a little bit covering your mood, for instance. So if you're kind of having a bad, wasn't that one? Yeah, a bad day. If you're feeling a little grumpy, if you're feeling extremely happy or something, then you can kind of change it around depending on what you feel up for, right? I think we're just gonna go with one of these standard ones. I think we're gonna do the one with the little tooth here for now. And of course we're gonna need a name. So we're gonna be Freya. I always love that name. Yeah, that's gonna be it. So create character. Haha, select. And then of course we're gonna make a new world. So I actually already typed this in earlier. Because I was messing around a little bit, but that is the one it's gonna be. So let's say okay. There we go, we landed. Yes, so we don't have much to start with. As you can see, we have a little bed here, we have a watering can and a little stone hoe. But that is definitely gonna change going forward, and you always start like on the 1st of spring. There are, if I remember correctly, 30 days. So you have like 30 days of spring, summer, fall, and winter, of course. There we go. So let's get back and get out of here and take a little look at our farmhouse. So of course, the idea is that you kind of take over after your grandparents. They went off on adventure, if I remember correctly. I think we're going to hear a little bit more about that in the story. And then we're gonna rebuild this farm. You can see there's not much here right now. And there's also a bunch of stuff that we can build ourselves. So, when you want to save in this game, then you need to save over here. You need to go to sleep. Of course, I don't want to do that right now, but the day ends at, I don't even remember if it's, I think it's midnight, or is it 11 o'clock? I feel like it's 11 o'clock, but maybe it's midnight. Then there's no penalty. So even if you are out in the world somewhere, and you just kind of drop to the ground when the day ends, and then you wake up in your bed, you're not going to be penalized. It's not like you're going to have less energy. You can see your energy down here. I only have 50 now. This can, you can get more over time. There's also ways you can regenerate via food and stuff. But when you want to sleep, you just go to your bed, or you just wait until that certain time. And if you're like at 3 o'clock and you want to pass time, you want it to be night time, you can use this little hammock. So you can take a nap just like this. You can sleep up to 16 hours. This is handy sometimes if you just want to go through. There's very short, very few things you want to do and you want to pass on to the next day, because a lot of events in the game and quests and stuff is like per day. So to progress, you need to move on to the next day, and then the hammock can be really, really handy. You also generate some energy, actually. So this can also be a way, if you just need a little bit of energy to plant one more plant, then you can just take a nap for an hour or something, and that might be enough. A really nice feature. I like that they added this. So anyway, let's get talking with Frank here. I'm Frank. I manage all the construction work in town. Your grandparents asked me to fix up your home before they left. So to progress the conversation here, you can either left click or you can press space. Could you collect 10 pieces of wood for your shop sign, and then you'll be set to open your shop at 12 p.m. You can pick them up from the ground or craft an axe by pressing T. Nice. Okay, yes, I want that. Or you could press E to accept it. So let's take a little look around. I already picked up a little bit of wood, as you saw. You can just walk up to things like this, and then you press E. And picking up wood or stones, I think, is there some more stones? There's little stones over here. Doesn't take energy. And that is another thing I really like in this game. There are things you can do that doesn't take energy. So even if you end up using all your energy because you're watering and replanting a lot of stuff, or you have been mining or whatever you have been doing, and you used up all your energy and it's only like noon on that day, then there's still a bunch of things you can do. You can also fish without using up any energy. You can also, oh nice, there's a little chest over there. These things you can have as plant fiber, for instance. You can see my energy is still at 50. Let's see if we find something good over here. Oh, we got some daisies. Well, we're definitely gonna need some of those, so that's fine. But you can find much more interesting things in the chests when you're lucky. You can always also harvest flowers, but this is gonna, see, that cost a little bit of energy. There we go, and we can press I to get in here. So let's just put our daisies up here. We have a bunch of things. There we go. I know I'm kind of explaining a little bit of things, but it's just in case someone is new to the game, then they then I'm just gonna tell a little bit about these things. Then of course we have our little shop table. This is your shop table. You can place items you want to sell here. You can open your shop between 12 and 6 p.m. So you just put some stuff in here. We could, they don't really give much, but you just put them in there. And right now we only have 3 slots. We have 1 table, but as you progress in the game, you can upgrade your shop and you will be able to sell more items in your shop as you get further along. Then he did say press T. You can also just press your inventory like I. And then you have like your quest log, you have a map, you have, this is the crafting. Then we have an overview of achievements. Of course, some of these I have already completed. It actually starts at 0. Oh, that's cool. So it shows for that specific character. Of course, some of these I've already completed on my other characters, but there's some things you can unlock via the achievements, like items or recipes in the game. So of course it's a really good thing that it's per character, so you can still do it if you make a new character. And then we have some little tutorials over here. But if we wanted to make an axe for cutting down bushes and trees, then we would need a wooden pole and a stone block. Can we make that? A wooden pole, yes. We just need two pieces of wood, so let's do that. We need another piece of stone. Let's see, I think I saw one over here. We don't have to do it. We could also just pick up more stuff on the ground like we just did, but let's just do this so that we can see how this works. So, stone block, craft. And then we go to stone axe, craft. There we go, it's just instant, and we have it right here. And of course, there's gonna be a whole bunch of workstations that we are gonna get later. And it takes more hits, so you do have to take into account if you're close to running out of stamina, which of course we aren't. But this tree is gonna take a lot more hits. There we go, it's gonna take us 4 hits, and that means it takes 4, like, slices of your stamina bar when you harvest it, whereas this one only takes 2. So that's something to think about when you're close to running out. You might want to go for the little ones because you might only have stamina for that. There we go, but we have enough now, so let's have a little chat with Frank. Hey, thanks a lot. Your shop is all ready to open. If you need any other work done around your farm, my shop is just inside of town on the hill. See ya. Nice. Okay, so he went back to town, and we're gonna spend a lot of time talking to him later, but now we got this fancy little shop sign. Yeah. So it can only open between 12 and 6, yes. So, and of course you have to have some stuff to actually sell, otherwise there's no point in opening it. But we're getting more into this later. We also have a little starting chest right here. So let's just drop this off because then we might need some of this, but let's just leave it here because then I have room to pick up some more stuff. Let's just put you up here. There we go, that's our starting chest, but we can craft more as we progress. There's also a little trash can over here, which you can use to anything you put in here is gonna be deleted. Oh, it popped up kind of afterwards. Item placed in a trash can be destroyed or will be destroyed. Ah, nice. So, of course, we are gonna want to do some. I didn't even mean to do it there. No. Oops. But it is fine. I just forgot that I put this away. But yeah, you to plant something, you dig a little hole like this, and then of course you have to be on the right spot on your hotbar, as you can see. So I have to be on 4, and then you just plant your seed. Make sure to water the seed every day. That's important because all these actions right here, digging, planting, and watering, all takes energy. So you have to make sure you have enough energy to actually do this. So if you have stuff that is planted, as you can see, it will disappear if you don't water it. So there we go, we have it watered. So make sure to check this every morning before you run out and do something else. If you have a lot of stuff planted, that you make sure to water it. They even have this little bar. I haven't noticed that before. I think it's something that has been added since I last played. I guess it shows how close we are to being able to harvest it, because some plants will take, I think, up to 4 days before they're finished, whereas some of them are finished already the next day, or may only take 2 days. Oh, wow, there's so much to do. It's so funny when you start brand new. I don't even know how to start. But there's another thing to take into account if you're gonna be building something yourself, which you probably will. Do not build anything right over here, because this spot, there's some commissioned buildings that will be built right here. You can't see it now, but you will be alerted about it once you get to those quests and you're gonna complete them things. Then they will tell you this is gonna be finished in however long time it's gonna take, and that you have to remove everything in the area. So it's a good idea not to build anything, unless they change that you can move them, but I don't think they have. Then we're gonna have some stuff here, so it's much better to find somewhere else to build. And you can build pretty much anywhere you want. The only place you can't build is over here on this main island, which is where the Florence town is. So let's see, we got some mail. Welcome to Florence. From the mayor. Nice. Our town is small for now, but with your help, we will grow. There are people wanting to join our town every day, but we need houses and shops for them first. Everyone is excited to meet you. We hope you enjoy your time here. Mayor Wilson. Oh, that's very sweet of him, right? Got a little welcome message. There we go. Let's close that down. So let's go into town and try and meet a few people, I think. We just planted one little flower, but we're just getting started. And the nice thing is, there is no hurry, guys. Like, if you don't finish something today, you can finish it tomorrow. A lot of quests are like you get a quest and you complete whatever it is. And when you hand it in, you often have to come back the next day to talk to that person to kind of progress. So that's the only way where you can feel a little bit like you're in a hurry. Oh, I got a little achievement. Is that the more, of course, you can manage to complete on this day, the more you will have access to the next day. But in general, there's nothing to hurry about. The only thing is the seasonal events. Oh, there's a little bubble there. That is something we're going to get into later, what we can do with that. But of course, there are some events for summer, for autumn, for winter. And of course, if you want to do any of that stuff, you have to do it before that month, or well, it's kind of like a month, you know, you have 30 days of a season. So before spring ends, you have to finish everything you want to do for the spring event. Otherwise, you just have to wait until the next year in game, but then you can continue where you left off. There's always going to be new quests related to all these events in your game as you progress. So anyway, lots of rambling, I know. I'm also trying to remember myself how all the details are in the game, but we have another chest. Oh, we got a chef hat. Nice. Let's just equip it, and eventually we will be able to color this, actually. What's up with this? Oh, there we go. It was just a little delayed. But look at that. We got our own little chef hat. Very nice. I actually wanted to... Oh, I don't think I can do this yet. I don't think I can get over there. Can I swim that far? There might be something we need. No, I think we can swim. Maybe we can swim. Oh, can we make it? Ooh, we can. Nice. I wasn't sure if we're going to need some help to actually make it. But even if, you know, if that little bar runs out, you're not going to die when this, you know, this little circle. You'll just end up back where you started. It just blocks you from accessing certain areas. There we go. Let's get a little bit of honey, because you can't get that much of this in the beginning. So I'm thinking we should start collecting it right off the bat. There we go. Most things will respawn, like trees and plants, and like the honey you will be able to harvest more every day. But I know we're going to need some of it, so we might as well get some of it right now, right? We're not getting much done today. It's the first day and it's already 4 o'clock, but that's okay. I'm not going to worry about it. There's times when we don't use up all our energy in a day, but that's just how it is, and it's okay. No need to hurry. Look at these fancy houses. This is also something they actually added since I stopped playing. You can now buy these houses for 5,000. Purchase this one bedroom house for 5,000 coin. So there's more houses that you can use. You can build your own, of course, too. But I think they all cost, yeah, 5,000. But this was mostly added also for multiplayer. Because if you play with a friend, then you only have one farmhouse, but your friend, you might want to have your own building to decorate, right? And then you can buy one of these, and then one of them can be your friends, and one of them can be, or you might have the farm, or maybe you each have your own house, and then you share the farm, kind of, however you want to do it. So let's just see if we can find a couple of people to talk to before this day ends. Because we have a lot of people to meet, as you can see. And this is only some of them, guys. There is going to be a lot more people that arrive in this place. So we are going to be busy. Hey, I'm Conrad. I'm the captain of that fine vessel floating on the docks. While you're here, could you tell Frank his order is ready to be picked up? Sure, I can do that. We are going to be doing a lot of errands like this. Look at this fine little vessel. Yeah, it's a really nice rowboat. There we go. But yeah, these guys don't seem to talk much with each other. So we're going to be doing a lot of errands and kind of giving messages from one person to the next. Hello, I'm Charlie. I keep the citizens of Florence safe. Don't worry, I've got your back. Nice. Okay, so right now we're just kind of meeting everybody. Do we have it as a quest, actually? Yeah, pending. It doesn't actually show. It says meet Conrad the Captain, but we already did. But we do have a quest related to it. And you can see done, meet Charlie. So it doesn't actually show you. You just find out as you progress that you have kind of met these people. Hi there, I heard you run a shop here in town. If you ever need help with running your shop and don't mind sharing some of the profit, you are in luck. We can help work the register and even open your shop for you for a fee of only 30% of the sales. I, for one, find this very, very expensive, so I haven't made use of it, but I can imagine if you're really, really far in a game and you have unlocked pretty much everything and you have tons of stuff to sell all the time, then it might be worth it to just let them, you know, open up the shop, and then you have this assistant that will be selling stuff while you're out doing other stuff. But I haven't used it myself at all. It's definitely not something I would do early in the game. Whenever you're ready to hire us, simply hire an assistant for the day with the signpost beside me. If you'd rather, we have a more convenient option. Frank can install a sign in your shop for 10,000 coin. Once the sign is set up, you will be able to request an assistant right from your shop instead of coming all the way here. Looking forward to working with you. Cool. Okay, well, let's see. We don't actually have any pickaxes yet, but this is one of the places. Of course, we can mine rocks. Then we have little geodes here you can mine, and then you have that can give you different ores. And then there's coal. There we go. We're gonna have to make some tools and stuff, guys. We're just taking it very casually and relaxed here. Oh, we got some pink leaves. Thank you. There we go. And chests will kind of also just respawn. So every day there will be chests somewhere in the game. A lot of them are in, you know. Oh, there's one more over there. I like chest hunting. Oh, treasure hunting. Just seeing what we can get. And as you can see, there's a lot of people to talk to, lots of quests to do. There we go. Got a little bit of cabbage too. So let's do this. Yep, let's go up and talk to Frank, because Frank is right here. And of course, if you look here, you can see this can be quite helpful to help you find people, because it can be a little hard to remember where everybody is until you kind of learn, of course. What are you doing down here? Usually he's standing up there. I don't know what he's doing underneath for once. Oh, it's here already. Thanks, I'll go pick it up later on. Here's a little something for delivering the message. Oh, nice. We got 10 wood. Thank you. Oh, right. So if we press F, he sells some wood and some stone. I've never actually bought any from him, but you can do it if you have a lot of money and you just want to do that. We're going to spend a lot of time coming back to this. You can buy upgrades for the town or your home here. So if you press E, you can see there's a chicken coop and a shop and stuff. If you want to have a better overview, you can click on this. Then you can see, oh, there's a whole bunch of stuff here that you can unlock. But there's more buildings than what you see here. Some things get added as you progress in the game. At least if I remember correctly, I think there's more stuff than what you can see here. I think there's some more buildings that get added later on. Yeah, we are going to spend a lot of time trying to open some of this stuff up. And as you build some of these, or get these things built in town, they often bring a quest line. So there will often be a person that comes with it, and then you suddenly have a long quest line with a lot of quests to do. So trust me, guys, with this game, you're going to be busy. Hello, I'm Jenna. I run a lemonade stand. When you're low on energy, come see me. When you need that extra bit of energy, try napping in your hammock in front of your house for an hour. Oh, thank you for that tip. And we got a little bit of lemonade. Very nice. Hey, I'm Malou. I run the fabric and dyes shop here in town. Here's a little something to welcome you to the town. Nice, thank you. So we got a little cloth. Very sweet of you. See who else we have. Hi there, I'm Abby. I run the cabbage shop. Come see me for all your cabbage needs. Here's a housewarming present. Welcome to town. And yeah, these people actually have, if you just press E, oh, she sells seeds now. Oh, nice. I don't think she used to. I think that's a new. If I remember correctly, she didn't actually in the beginning, but she does now. So you can buy some seeds from her, among other places. We're not going to do that right now. What do you sell? I forgot to check. Okay, yeah, so you can buy some cloth here. We can craft some of that ourselves too. And over here, we can buy lemons and lemonade. So let's see, what time is it? 8. Hey, I'm Boris. My brother is Clovis. I can solve all your storage needs, from backpacks to chests. We have them both. Come see me if you ever need storage solutions. When we get a custom shop built in town, you'll be able to meet Clovis, my brother. See you around. So this is what I was talking about. If you build the custom shop or commission it from Frank, then Clovis will arrive and he will, or most of these people actually have their own like quest lines that you can do. There we go. So if we want a backpack upgrade, which gives us 5 extra inventory slots, then we're gonna need 20,000. We can also buy an extra chest, because I don't have the money for it, but it adds an extra chest. The only thing with these is you can't move them, so they have a set location, like the chest we already have in at home. This one will have a specific location it gets placed in, but we'll also be able to craft some ourselves later. And there we go. Do I have enough that I could actually make a pickaxe now? We might get one via a quest, I don't really remember, but I don't have enough stone for it. Ah, it's no hurry. It's because I can hear there's a chest hidden in here, but we can break these stones apart. Can I pick this up? No. Okay. Welcome to Florence. I'm Mayor Wilson. You're welcome to gather any items you find in the area and build anywhere outside of the town. I almost forgot to mention, your grandparents left you a couple of tutorials. I've equipped them in your tutorial menu that you can access by pressing I and selecting tutorials. Ooh, nice. And what's a coin bag used for? This I've never seen before either, so I guess maybe it's a decorative item? So it costs 1,000 and you get a coin bag. Oh, that is so cool. Nice. Oh, and there's so much that's gonna change. The town is gonna look so much different as we unlock different things. And let's see, it's 9 o'clock. I know, I'm not really gathering any resources. I could actually be doing that along the way. A little bit. I'm just kind of trying to do all these little welcome quests. There we go. So let's just pick that up. But let's grab a little bit of wood. As long as you're close enough, these things just kind of pop into your inventory. There we go. Nice, got a little bit more wood. We could cut down the big trees as well, of course. Just so we get a little bit of resources. Howdy, partner. Welcome to the town. I'm Jones, the chicken farmer. Nice to meet you. If you ever want to raise chicks, come see me. Here's a little housewarming present. Ooh, so we got a little bit of wheat. That is nice. And of course, he has a shop too, where we can buy a little chick, which will then grow up. You have to feed it every day, though. And then there's bird feed that you're going to have to feed to these to let them grow up. Here we go. And we can. Let's go in here. And we're gonna, I think we have room, right? Yes, so we're gonna steal some of this stuff. Let's try not to hit them with the axe. Not that it matters, but I feel bad when I do it. Ooh, we can give you a little bit of loving. There we go. Look at these guys. Aren't they adorable? Everything in this game is just adorable. Man. Oh boy. Let's pick up a bit of this. I'm just kind of picking a little bit of everything here. Okay, so it's 10 o'clock. Oh, look at that. There's a shooting star. And... oh boy. Might be able to get it. I think we're gonna try and see if we can just talk to Mr. Mooney here. Hey partner, I'm Mr. Mooney. I run the best farm here in Florence. See you around. There we go. So we have kind of done that. There's stuff there that we could pick up too, but I want this star over here before the day ends. So the shooting stars always fall around 10 or at 10 actually. 10 p.m. There we go, you can also pick this up, then you can get sand and stuff. But we are filling up our inventory a lot here. There we go, so... nice! Unlocked Fallen Starlight Blueprint. And we got a little achievement, Wish Upon a Star. Oh, it's a good thing I didn't pick anything else up. Look at that, we got a falling star, that is so pretty. It is so pretty. Well, I think I'm just gonna... yeah, okay, so it is midnight. I couldn't really remember. For some reason, I wonder it makes sense. It's midnight that the day ends. But I couldn't really remember. I just felt like it was, like, at 11. But then you can see it's... you have to be fast. Because the stars, if you don't get them, they will despawn. So you can't pick it up the next day. Oh, I don't have room. You know what? We're just gonna... yes, grab these, because I would rather have the wood. We can use these for fish bait, but I would rather have the wood. There we go. So let's just start heading home. But that is pretty much our first day. We didn't really get that much done. We have met a lot of people, but they will probably start having stuff for us to do when we wake up in the morning and we go back to town. See, now it's about, we are about to pass out. Boom, and then you get a little daily stat so you can see how much gold you earned and spent, how much you harvested, and all these things. The game is being saved. And then you just press ready. Here we go, we're gonna load in, which sometimes takes a little while. There we go, and then, oh, you spawn out here. That's new, you used to spawn on the bed, but okay. But I'm not gonna do anything right now. Then you this is the time you log off your game. If you wanna make sure it's saved, then you don't do anything else. You just say, okay, that's it. And then when you jump back into the game, this is where you're gonna start up out, where you can water your plant and everything. But that was it, kind of the start to the little series, guys. Let me know what you think, guys. Also about the starting over part. You boy, we're gonna have so much to do. And do tell me everything about how it's going for you guys. I know some of you are playing this yourself or have been playing for a long time. Maybe you already unlocked everything in the game, or maybe you are just starting out just like me. So yeah, thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.